And I was like, why would they do a test at 4:45 in the morning?
That was the million-dollar question early this morning. Around 4:45, phones all across Florida started beeping and buzzing with that emergency alert. Well, turns out it was just a test, and it was sent by accident.
It was, you know, a little disconcerting that early in the morning to be blasted out of your bed.
It was stupid, and it woke me up first thing this morning. I just kind of, like, laid there. I didn't go back to sleep, though.
Emergency management officers have concerns that this mistake is going to lead to people turning off the alerts on their phones, and we do not want that ahead of hurricane season.
The only way for emergency officials, the government, to notify the community of tornadoes, wildfires, evacuations. This is our one way of getting information to the public.
The Florida Department of Emergency Management says they're going to fire the company that they pay to handle the alerts.
Hey, are you one of the people in Florida like me that didn't get that EAS alert test this morning and now you're worried you might miss an actual EAS alert if it's issued in the future? Here's what to check on your phone to make sure your settings are up to date. First thing you'll want to do is tap where it says settings in your phone. Where it says notifications, at the bottom of the screen, tap where it says advanced settings. On the menu that appears at the very bottom of the page, you'll find the words wireless emergency alerts. Tap on that and scroll down. Now, my phone's default was to have state and local tests off. Now that I've turned it on, I would have received that alert like everybody else. While you're here, make sure extreme threats, severe threats, amber alerts, and public safety messages are all turned on. I totally get those alerts can sometimes be a little annoying, and they were really stressful during Hurricane Ian. But look, when emergency managers issue things like evacuation orders, that's the first way they push it out to the public. So make sure you have all those settings on.
Now, if that was too fast, I've got the whole step-by-step guide for you on the NBC2 app and nbc-2.com. It's written for Android users, but if you have an iPhone, you're looking for similar things, just the wording and the images on your screen might be a little different. Please, please do not turn off all EAS alerts, because in true emergency situations like we all went through together 7 months ago with Hurricane Ian, those things can be lifesavers, despite what happened earlier today with that mistaken test.